stupa is a semi-spherical mound. It is a semi-spherical mound marked to identify a place of significance. Identify a place of significance associated with the life of Buddha or Bodhisattva. Place of significance associated with the life of Buddha or Bodhisattva. Bodhisattva means somebody who has reached Buddhahood. He is like an enlightened man only, but he is not exactly Buddha. He is somebody else. Maybe the disciple of Buddha. Bodhisattva. Now we will speak about the architectural significance. It is a semi-spherical mound, I told you. The material used to build this stupa happens to be burnt and unburnt bricks. Both were used in the initial stage. Sometimes rocks were also used, but normally burnt and unburnt bricks were used. Outside layer burnt bricks, inside layer unburnt bricks. Unburnt bricks. History says that Ashoka had constructed 84,000 stupas. 84,000 stupas. After he being influenced by Buddhism after the Battle of Kalinga in 261 BC. After the Battle of Kalinga in 261 BC. And the stupa, around the stupa, we have something which is called a railing. Railing, R-E-I-L-I-N-G, railing. It is a fence to the stupa. Fence. Initially the railings were made of wood. Later, stone was used as a material for the railings. Stone was used as a material for the railings. The important stupa, but the existence of railings today happens to be Sanchi Stupa. Sanchi. Sanchi Stupa in Madhya Pradesh near Bhopal. And there were entrances to the stupa through the railings. They are called as Toranas. T-O-R-A-N-A-S. Toranas. Four direction entrances. These Toranas represent the beautiful piece of sculpture. Toranas represent a beautiful piece of sculpture. Toranas. The sculptures, what are the themes which are represented in the sculptures? Jataka stories or previous life stories of Buddha are mentioned. Previous life stories of Buddha are mentioned in the Jataka stories. And events associated with Buddha's life is also mentioned. Events associated with Buddha's life is also mentioned. Then we have in the stupa something which is called a pradakshina patha, circumbatory path. Circumbatory path, pradakshina patha, where a person is supposed to go around in prayer or whatever it is. Next we have something which is called a harmika, H-A-R-M-I-K-A. Harmika is a small casket on the top of the stupa. Harmika. Harmika. In this harmika, H-A-R-M-I-K-A, which is a small casket or a small box, normally a relict of Buddha or Bodhisattva is placed. Relict of Buddha or Bodhisattva is placed. On top of this harmika, or the harmika is shadowed by something which is called chathar, C-H-A-T-A-R, chathar, or a small umbrella like feature. Chathar. Most of the rulers in ancient India who were influenced by Buddhism helped in the construction of the stupas, support of the stupas. The important stupas in India happens to be, one is Sanchi, another we have Sarnath stupa also is existing. Sarnath. The remains of the Amaravati stupa is also found. Remains of Amaravati stupa is also found.